therapeutic. And exactly what part of I'm taking a bath did you take to mean come on in?
Well, I'm sorry to tax your delicate system, but Daphne's back, and she and Sherry are at it again, and now she says she's going to stay overnight with Niles, and I don't know what to do, and this is your department.
All right, unless blood has been spilled and on a carpeted area, I don't care. Now get out.
Oh, there you are. Marty, I tried, but that girl has no manners whatsoever. Hey, Frasier.
Do you mind?
I knew I'd find you in here. Whatever they're telling you about me is not true.
Daphne, please, you can't come in here.
Why? She can.
No, she can't. No one can.
Frasier, have you no decency? Daphne, let's go.
All right. I am moments away from succumbing once and for all to this fool. But I will take one stab at this, and then I am going to sink hippopotamus-like beneath the bubbles. I think what this all comes down to is a dispute over turf. Daphne and Sherry are like two animals scent marking their territory, which in this case is you, Dad.
You couldn't come up with a less disgusting comparison?
All right, fine. It's like the Roman Emperor Tiberius, his mother Livia, and his wife Vipsania.
What?
Huh?
Oh.
Go on.
All right. Daphne, your primary role in this household is to take care of Dad. Sherry, you also enjoy taking care of Dad. I suspect that your attempts to find Daphne a boyfriend are really an unconscious ploy to get her out of the way. It's unconscious. Daphne, naturally you're threatened by this. You feel that you're no longer needed.
I have been feeling a bit unwanted lately.
Oh, well, a night without your services will have them singing a different tune. Let's go.
Yes, Daphne, no one is going to be singing anything tonight, all right? But Daphne, I think we now all understand why you stormed out of here earlier. Strong emotion like not feeling wanted can drive anyone to a rash and impulsive act.
Yes, it nearly did. Mm. I mean, yes, it did.
Yes, well, at the root of this, you're both just feeling insecure.
Exactly.
It very possibly could have been avoided if Dad had been sensitive enough to remind you that you're both important in his life.
What are you saying, that it's my fault?
Well, I must admit, a few reassuring words might just have done the trick.
Marty does have difficulty expressing his feelings.
No, I don't.
Oh, Sherry.
Oh, save it, honey. It wasn't our fault.
Yes, it was. You said that she was skinny and you said she was Big Mac.
That is not important. We all feel better now.
Well, I don't.
Well, God, all right, look, I am running out of patience, I'm running out of strength, and I'm running out of bubbles. Please, the lecture has ended.
You're a good psychiatrist, Dr. Crane.
You sure are, hon. You see, Marty, it isn't just a lot of hooey.
Thank you very much.
Oh. Please, Niles. Look, unconsciously you knew that it wasn't right. That's why you brought Daphne back here.
No, we came back to fetch her damn thyroid pills.
You're a doctor. Why didn't you just use your prescription pad?
Oh, my God.
Isn't there an all-night pharmacy across the street from your building?
Oh, my God.
Hey, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salads and scrambled eggs. Mercy. And maybe I seem a bit confused. Well, maybe, but I got you pegged. But I don't know what to do with those tossed salads and scrambled eggs. They're calling again.